London, Kevin Cerulli. Kevin, looking forward to this one. Take it away.
Thank you, Jonathan. Senator Warren, thank you for joining me. First things first, what do Democrats want in order to get this economic stimulus bill over the finish line?
Okay, so part one is we want to make sure that we are investing in the health and safety of the American people. That means enough money going to hospitals and community health centers and that there's free testing for everyone. Part two, we want to make sure that money is going to the grassroots level. And that means expanded unemployment insurance so that we're covering gig workers and part-time workers and raising the amount. We need that money in people's pockets. We need cash in people's pockets. But also we need to be thinking about other ways to relieve the stress on families. Canceling student loan debt, for example, means a lot more money in the pockets of a lot of young people. Adding $200 a month to Social Security and disability payments for the next couple of years helps people who are living at the economic margin. But we want to make sure that's where help is going. Third one, we need to get relief out for small businesses. You know, these small businesses employ a lot of people, and right now they've been shut down, certainly through no fault of their own. They need help, and they need it fast. And then fourth, any kind of help that goes to the big industries has got to come with some strings attached, which means making sure that taxpayer dollars are not used just for stock buybacks and to make sure that that CEOs get their bonuses this year, but that it's really used to support payroll. That's what we want to see.
Well, Senator, let me follow up on that fourth point that you made, because
sure.
I think that's based upon my reporting where a lot of the sticking points still lie. President Trump, for his part, has said he doesn't want to see stock buybacks either. But behind the scenes, when the sausage is getting made in this bill, can you get specific for me and for our audience on specifically, Senator, when it relates to that $500 billion for larger businesses, what you think needs to get changed in order for this to get voted on this evening?
Sure. And I want to say I'm glad to hear that the president is in favor of some of the strings attached to this money. But it can't just be that we ask the businesses to promise that they're going to do this. We have to write it into law. So restrictions on stock buybacks are part of it. That the money is being used to support payroll is an important part of it. That the companies are truly investing in their workers, not using this money for executive pay, for example. And that there is an oversight panel that makes sure that the money is spent according to the law and according to the promises that have been made. An oversight panel that has real teeth. And part of that means that the corporate executives who take this money have to sign under penalty of law that their companies are complying with all of the laws and rules and regulations. That's how we make sure that if taxpayer dollars are being used, then the taxpayers are the ones who are truly being served here.
Senator, it's Jonathan here. Great to have you with us on the program.
Yeah.
And thanks
good
for giving us
here.
Your time. They say that perfection is the enemy of the good. Are you looking for the perfect bill?
Look, you always want to aim for perfect. That's exactly what we should be doing. But do I recognize there'll be some compromises along the way? Of course there will be compromises along the way. But understand this. We have to have strings attached before we give a half a trillion dollars away to giant corporations. We need to make sure that money isn't just going to big corporations,
yeah.
That it's going to people who are struggling to pay student
loan debts
right now.
Senator, let's talk about it.
What compromises
are you willing to make?
Well, how about one on student loans? I'd like to see us forgive all of the debt on student
loans.
That's
not a compromise. What compromise are you willing to make in the bill that's been put forward so far?
If you'd let me finish,
sure.
I would like to see all of the debt forgiven on student loans. Right now, the proposal on the table is to forgive the interest and to forgive $10,000 worth of debt for each student. I could live with that. I think that's a good place for us to start, and it relieves the pressure on a lot of people who are living really close to the economic margin. The notion that the federal government should be out there squeezing dollars out of people who are losing their jobs, who are living in this time of economic uncertainty. uncertainty makes no sense at all. It's harmful to the individuals and it's harmful to our economy. So I see a compromise there. Let's do that. Increasing payments on Social Security and disability. Look, I'd like to see them go even higher, but $200 a month every month for the next couple of years, that would lift more than 5 million people out of poverty. It would mean that seniors who are locked at home right now and have to use food delivery services and spend more on health care will at least have a little cushion in their budget. Those are the kinds of things I'd like to see us do, and I'm perfectly willing to compromise on the numbers. In fact, I think we've already done that. But we need the Republicans to move, to say yes, they are willing to help on student loans, they are willing to help on unemployment insurance, they are willing to help on Social Security and disability, and let's negotiate over the dollar.
Senator,
numbers.
We're up against the clock, so I have to keep jumping in, so forgive me. In this bill, there are checks for everyday Americans. The reason this bill hasn't gone through is because of Democratic senators. Do you want to be the person that's stopping people from getting their checks to meet their rent at the end of this month?
Excuse me. The reason this bill has not gone through is because of Republican senators and because of a Republican leadership that pretended to negotiate for 3 days with the Democrats and then at the end of that time basically introduced their own bill. Their own bill that did not have compromises and that did not make sure that the money is going down to the grassroots. Look, it's going to take people from both parties to get this through. Now, we've laid out what our principles are, and that is you can't give a half a trillion dollars to giant industry and not help people at the
grassroots. So, Senator, why don't we strip out the bailout side of the bill? Spend the rest of the week debating that and then get through the rest and get it done quickly so people can actually receive some money.
So I'd love to strip out the bailout part of the bill and just concentrate on student loans, unemployment insurance, on increasing Social Security, on getting help to small businesses, and on making sure we're getting the money to our hospitals and our testing facilities. I'm glad to do that, Bill. Let's do it right now.
Can we strip out the payments, the checks to Americans, and can we do that today? Senator, I don't think there's enough urgency on Capitol Hill. I've been frustrated with this for weeks now on both sides of the aisle. You guys can get this done. The only thing stopping it from happening is yourselves on both sides of the aisles. And there's no point coming on the TV shows today on the networks and saying it's the Republicans' fault. Because you know what's happening on the other networks? It's the Democrats' fault. It's all of your fault. Get around a table, strip it out, pass the bill with the checks in so people can get those checks in 1 week, in 2 weeks' time.
So I am glad to sit down and get money into the pockets of people right now. I think we can do that with cash. I think we can do that by cutting student loan payments. We can do that by expanding unemployment insurance, and we can do that by expanding Social Security. I've been talking about all four of these 4 weeks now. I have put forward those proposals. And right now, we don't have Republicans to negotiate with on those issues. They're not there. So you tell me what you want to do. You want to bring one on this program? That's fine with me.
I will do just that, Senator.
But this is the kind of thing that puts money directly into the hands of people who are suffering. I want to do that right now. I will stay here. I will work around the clock to make that happen. But we've got to keep the focus on money into the hands of people who are struggling right now. We are not going to rebuild this economy by putting a bunch of money at the top. We need that money going down.
Senator, I totally agree. It needs to happen quickly. But let me tell you, we won't be playing the blame game and letting you guys dictate who is to blame. If you guys don't get this done, it's every single one of you that needs to be held responsible for it. Both parties, the whole of Washington. Senator Warren, great to catch up with you. And Bloomberg's Kevin Cerruti, thank you very much for joining us as well. Coming up on the program, the market moving event.